sounds like a fantasy, right? But then there always comes that one time where things just kind of turn sour. And here's the story. Once upon a time, in a land very, very near, there lived a prince on a throne that destroyed the lives of all those he called dear. One poor decision, he now has to face anyone with fear. Sharp fangs, long claws, and full of fur is how he appears. Arrogant, gruesome, and vicious, just a few words for lack of better terms. Selfish, shameful, malicious, with an anger so hot that his blood begins to burn. It's not a drastic understatement to say he has a short fuse. He's a beast, for all who reside with him have become nothing more than tools. The clock, the candle, you name it, it's alive. All sentenced to live like this until the day they die, simply because one foul prince couldn't lay down his pride. Between his humanity and his monstrosity, he rests on this great divide. But he's been given a time. If he can fulfill the requirement, it will release the bind. But if not, he's forced to live in this hell until the end of time. Some grains of sand later, he's still watching that hourglass, wondering if he'll ever revert back or if the opportunity will just come and pass. But then a marvelous beauty wanders into his domain, but he locks her in the dungeon while fueled by his rage. He then allows her access to the castle, but she's only allowed access to a certain section. But he had a problem. She found her way to his most prized possession, so it provoked and threatened him, so he hurled bloodlust and aggression. So she left him. And she left without giving it a second thought, never to be seen again. Or so he thought. You see, when she was attacked, for her, he stood and he fought. And he finally expressed that she found her way into his heart. Afterwards, when he was hurt, she sat there and helped him through. She put their differences aside and sat there helping him patch up every wound. And after that moment, I guess you could say there was a spark that wasn't there before. As time went on, day after day, he came to realize that it might be her that he adores. He finally found this feeling, this connection that he never had before. Almost as gentle as when the ocean waves kissed the sandy shore. As time went on, day after day, their bond grew more and more. But there was a time when he got tested and tried, and he had given up. And he was ready to die. But she was there standing by his side. And she reminded him of what was important in life. And it was almost like he was revitalized. And so he held on to his newfound mercy and showed grace upon those who would have otherwise been deemed unworthy. As time went on, he began to transform back into the dashing prince. He shed his humanity, or he regained his humanity, and shed his beast-like skin. It's the story of Beauty and the Beast. However, I want to rewind this reality check. We all want to play ruler like our sin don't exist. And then, before we know it, we got fur and claws that are covering our fists. Then we examine our situation and say, it's all good if that's it, but then we turn around and realize that we dragged our loved ones into this. We can't deal with that shame. We begin to isolate because we can't even look at those with our same last name. We can't stomach that pain. It's like, shoot, if it's gonna end like this, I might as well put the bullet in the brain. It's nauseating to think about. So we ignore our problems because we don't have a thing figured out. Like, here comes God, knock, knock, but we go ahead and kick him out. Knock, knock, but we kick God out. Knock, knock, we kick him out. Three times before the rooster crows, but it takes 5 moments to define a man and what he knows. Well, here's what we know. We're crowned owner of this dark, eerie place. And every time that we see a face, it only reminds us of past mistakes. All the times that we've hurt, all the times that we've fallen in pain, or when we give others that same pain. However, our only salvation can come from the knock and the light that shows. It marked a new day when the sun rose. And the only reason why we can walk straight is because the sun rose. So open that door before the rooster crows. Let him turn your dark fortress into a castle full of rose gold. Thank you.
Amen. Beautiful.